Chiefs go to 4-1, a fourth consecutive win. 27-20, the final. Let's go to James Brown in New York.
And we take you to New York Jets against the Denver Broncos. 23 seconds left in regulation. Let's join the announcers, Andrew Catalan, Tiki Barber, Matt Ryan, and A.J. Ross.
Sean Payton was not happy with Russell Wilson after that sack fumble. As you see him, he's just laying into him a little bit. Throw the ball out of bounds, throw it away.
That's what I thought Andrew was asking about prior. It's the rub with him. I mean, he makes so many plays extending it, so many big plays he's made throughout his career. I think in this situation right here, though, you've got 23 seconds left. You're trying to get something to the 40-yard line, kick a field goal, and then try and throw up the Hail Mary.
Denver is out of timeouts. And the Jets have called the timeout with 23 seconds remaining. This was billed by some as the Hackett Bowl. Nathaniel Hackett, Denver's head coach last year, now the Jets offensive coordinator. We told you about Sean Payton's comments over the summer, calling it one of the worst coaching jobs in the history of the NFL. And Nathaniel Hackett downplayed that all week, but you know this feels sweet.
Oh, he's loving this. You can see it. You see the side of his face when he turns again. He's got that oil right there on the side of his face where he's hugging everybody. I think that was from Mekhi Becton we gave a big bear hug to.
Hugging Todd Downing, the pass game coordinator. Be some interesting handshakes after this game as Russell Wilson steps up, throws deep for Judy, incomplete, stopping the clock with 17 seconds to go.
Yeah, I think for him, it's the first time he really let it sink in, too. You know, it's probably been stored somewhere in the back of his head. He didn't really want to talk about it. Was probably focusing on the X's and O's and how to put his guys in position to win this game. And now with the game at hand, the relief he does have to feel and how proud he is of the guys, because he mentioned that to us. You know, that the reason he does this is for the guys in that locker room to be able to celebrate with those guys after a win like today. It's going to be special for him.
And he's got Zach Wilson believing. Wilson told us last night that last week was the first time in the NFL that he felt a coach believed in him. And he was referencing Nathaniel Hackett. P-Ryan to midfield. Denver cannot stop the clock.
Yeah, just a desperation play here. He's trying to do anything to make a play. His game going to run out as it is.
Jets could be interesting going forward. They go to 2-3. They got to play Philly next week, but then a bye, and then their schedule softens a bit, and maybe they have some momentum and rhythm with Zach Wilson in the offense.
I think they're going to stay relevant because of their defense. I mean,
yes.
This defense in their front seven is one of the best in the league, and that's going to keep them relevant week in and week out. If Zach Wilson can continue to grow and make a few better decisions, the decision before the end of the half, just clean up a few things, take care of the football inside the pocket, and just learn from some of the mistakes that they made today, I think he can play well moving forward.
Final play, barring the penalty, Wilson's just going to throw one down the end zone. Broncos not completing the Hail Mary this year, not here, and the Jets stop a three-game losing streak. They win it 31-21. Sean Payton with Robert Saleh. Quick handshake as the Jets head back east to take on the Eagles, and a sweet win for Nathaniel Hackett. Meanwhile, the Broncos go to 1-4 and a quick turnaround Thursday night at Kansas City. Tonight on CBS begins with 60 Minutes, followed by Yellowstone and Big Brother. From Matt Ryan, Tiki Barber, A.J. Ross, Gene Steratore, our entire crew, this is Andrew Catalan saying so long from Denver. You've been watching the NFL on CBS, home of Super Bowl 58.
We love our...